Hey everyone, Jason here, digital marketing consultant and certified Canva creator. And in this Canva tutorial, we're going to be taking a look at how to put together an awesome lead magnet to grow your list and propel those leads into customers. So let's go ahead, jump straight in my screen, and there's a timestamp table of contents as well as a playlist to other tutorials to help you get up and running with Canva and show you the power of Canva. So here, the first thing I want to point out is we're going to be doing it 8.5 by 11, and there are a couple of templates that we actually have to choose from. So inside of Canva here, we can click Browse All, and this will pull up all of the templates that we have access to. There are a couple I want to point, just kind of highlight, so you can go through them and see if any of the templates that are inside of these designs will help you in creating your own lead magnet, because there are a lot to choose from. So the first template under Documents I recommend you checking out is Report. And then if we scroll down here to Education, if you're putting together something that's kind of a fill-in-the-blank style, then definitely checking out Worksheet and Lesson Plan templates would be great. And then under Marketing, not Infographics, but if we scroll a little further, you'll see Newsletter and Proposal. Proposal is actually my favorite so far. And then we can scroll down again to Ads, and we'll see Magazine Cover and Media Kit. And all you have to do is click on each one of these, and then it will load up a blank canvas. And in this blank canvas, it will automatically show you the templates that are available for this type of canvas. So you can just scroll through and see if there are any templates that you're interested in. So I recommend doing that for each one of the ones I pointed out, because one of them is bound to have a template that you can see yourself modifying for your own lead magnet. For me, I'm actually going to go straight to Proposal to save us some time. And then at the end of the video, I'll actually go through some examples of previous lead magnets that I've put together. So make sure you stick around for that. So here, there are two things that we're going to go through. I'm going to go through using just a proposal template to be quick and dirty as fast as possible. And then I'll show you how to put together your own template if you don't like anything that's here. And after scrolling through a couple of these templates, I'm going to go ahead and use this one. So we just click and we click again, it will automatically load it here into our canvas. I'll zoom in a little bit and then we'll add new page. It's important that you add a new page, and then we can click on the second template. What's nice about these is they're very clean. They're designed to have a lot of text, but they also give you spaces to just insert stock images, which is something I really like because we don't have to spend time making our own images. So this is obviously not a marketing proposal. This is going to be a lead magnet for video marketing. So we'll type in video and marketing. Switch that up there a little bit because marketing wasn't fitting. And when you have a text box like this, you'll see these are actually two text boxes. And you can come up here and click ungroup, and then you'll be able to individually move the two text boxes. So you can see I move this up like this, but if I control Z here and I try to do the same thing, it's going to make the whole thing bigger. So just keep that in mind when you're using elements that they've already put together for you. If you click on it and you see ungroup, that means you can ungroup everything and then change the size of the individual elements or all of the elements as I've done here. So black is a little boring, so we'll come up here and I'm actually going to change the font. So there are lots of different fonts here, and then we can just click and change it to whatever color we like. What's cool is even if you're just using the free account, you can load up to, I think, 3 or 4 colors. So if you have brand colors, you can just load them up here and they'll always be available to you inside of every single one of your designs. And some of the elements inside of Canva can actually be changed colored. And if they can, then you can just click on them and you'll be able to change the color. So we'll change it to orange or turquoise or blue. We'll do blue. Well, that doesn't look good. We'll do turquoise, whatever. You can always go back and change the colors if you don't like the way that they look. And as you can see here, just changing the colors so that it matches my brand more. And instead of this funny looking eye, I'm going to remove that. What we could do is we could come down to elements and we could search for something. So if we're doing video, I could click on this guy and make it nice and small and just have a play button over the name of the company for this. Or we could just search marketing and see what pops up for us. And we could either look at photos or we'll look at graphics. In this particular instance, we'll look at graphics. I like the way that one looks. That looks Great, so we'll go ahead and remove that one. And this one is free, and you can change the color, so we'll change it to white, and then we'll make it nice and small and center it over Act Marketing. And just like that, in a few minutes, we have a cover for our lead magnet. Now, this image here, maybe I want a different one. Let's go to my uploads and see if I have anything better. Let's say I want to use this picture, so I can click and drag. And what's cool about using templates is you can see I've clicked and dragged and I just moused it over the image that was already there and it automatically cropped and formatted it for me. So here we go. All I need to do is change the name. And boom, we're done. That's it. That's all there is to it. We've literally just put together the cover, which is the hardest part. And we're just using a basic proposal template. So I'll scroll down here. The first thing we're going to do, I'm going to jump cut ahead to changing all of the fonts and colors to what I want. And once I've done that, it's very important that you do choose one or two fonts to use for your entire lead magnet. I've seen some lead magnets in Canva where every single page has a different font. We definitely don't want that. We want congruency. And once I click duplicate, I know that I have a second page that's just like this. And now I can scroll back up so you can see I have two because I clicked duplicate. Now we can modify it for whatever pieces of content or images we want to have on the page. So maybe this is step number one. So I'll click step one. And call it the viewer. And then we could go through and enter in our own text. And at the bottom here, I recommend changing it to a call to action. Remember, the whole purpose of the lead magnet is to help move a new lead or prospect into doing business with you. And the best way to do that is to give them an opportunity to give you a call or to take a look at the next, whatever next sales message you have. So what we can do is we can actually highlight this and we can come up here to the top right and click link and enter a URL that we want people to be directed to. And then when we export this as a PDF, that's actually going to be a hyperlink that they can click. So if someone's scrolling through it and they go, oh, actually I do want to book a call or I want to learn more, they can easily click there. So I really like doing that because it makes sure that the lead magnet is actually helping propel people through your sales funnel, but it's also not kind of blatant in your face or getting in the way of the information you want to deliver. So that does it for putting together a lead magnet with a template. I really like this template. And of course, if you don't, then there are plenty of other templates that you can choose from. And there are plenty of other designs that you can choose from. Remember, in the beginning, you can go through magazine, media kit. We have a program was okay. I didn't really like the what they had in program. I'm using proposal right now, but you also have newsletter, you have worksheet, you have lesson plan. And then there's one more, and then you have report. So every time you click on one of those, you're going to get a different set of templates. So if you're still watching and you're getting some value, go ahead and hit that like button. What I'd like to do now is show you a couple of examples, and then I'll show you how to build a lead magnet template from complete scratch. So one of the examples I have for you here is an analytics checklist lead magnet we use for our agency, and it just walks people through things that are wrong with their analytics. And one of the reasons I wanted to show you this is because number one, you can see it's extremely simple. I'm gonna show you how to put together this template in a moment, but also if you have graphics or images, one of the things that's really nice to do is to use a rectangle and put it behind and then slightly down. So you can see that this is actually an element that's behind the image. And if we bring it up, it's the same size. But if I control Z, bringing it down a little bit casts this nice shadow. The other thing I like to do with lead magnets is have a why fix it or why this is important or pro tip or important note in each section. And I like just having a nice little image and then a grayed out area where it talks about what the pro tip is or the importance of what they are reading. So it's a great way to kind of add commentary to the facts or how-to information that you're providing. And I find that it's also a great way to handle buying objections. So let's go ahead and put this lead magnet together. We definitely have some other examples of lead magnets here. This is one that was put together in a previous video. So if you like the way this one looks, link in the description to that Canva tutorial. And that Canva tutorial also walks you through how I put together these using presentation templates and the presentation format. So let's go back to our awesome design and let's make one from scratch. So I'll come down all the way down here. I'm going to add a new page. And to make one from scratch, there are only a couple elements that we need. The first thing we need is a rectangle, then we need some text and an image, and we're all good to go. So first we'll start off with a rectangle, we'll bring it up here and just bring it to the top of the page. There we go. And then next we just need some text for our headline. So we can go through here and actually choose one of the group text that they already have. Let's go ahead and choose this one. Again, pay attention to your fonts. So this is probably a different, it's probably a different font. So I'm going to immediately change it to the fonts I've been using throughout the rest of this tutorial. And of course you can choose whichever ones you want. Then we need to resize it. And you'll see here it's pulling up and it's not bringing video and marketing on the same line, which I want it to. We'll click and drag. We'll get it in the right place. We'll get it in the right place first. And then we will click ungroup. So now that we've ungrouped it, we can click the video and marketing and click and drag so that it's actually one line. Now we can select both of them, bring them up, video marketing playbook, center it. We'd probably put playbook in the center to make it look a little better. Change the text to white. And now all we need is our logo and our image. So I'm going to go to uploads here and let's choose another image. We'll choose this one. This one looks halfway decent. We'll click and drag, center it with the top, and then we'll just click and pull until it's covering the entire page. And then we can click and center it or get it to cover up the rest of the canvas. And actually this is a pretty poor example since it looks like there's supposed to be something there. So let's go ahead and use an element to get some to make it not look like there's so much space. So I'm just going to type in video marketing, click on graphics, and luckily because I'm using the Canva for work, I can use this one. So we'll click and drag that one in there. And now we have video marketing playbook and like that. So not as glamorous as when we were doing the template, but just to show you that it doesn't take a tremendous amount of work to put together a title page. So now let's go ahead and put together a page that we can use for all of our content. So we'll go to elements. I'm clicking all over the place here. All right, so we'll go to elements, and this is kind of my go-to just default if I'm trying to put together something quick and just give it a nice value-driven look. So we'll come up here, we'll make that, and this is going to be our page counter. And we will copy and paste this and we'll bring it down to the bottom and we'll give it a nice bottom border as well. So again, it doesn't have to be super complicated. I mean, it's just about taking the text and valuable information you have for your prospects and sprucing it up a little bit. So we'll go to text, put in the page number 01, make it white, and then we'll click and drag it up and center it with that. And now we have a way to count our page numbers. And we have a nice bottom border. We could change the bottom border color, but essentially this is all you need for your blank template. And now you have this great canvas where you can put all the text and images and diagrams that you want. And with that, that concludes it. So we've built two lead magnets here and I've showed you some examples of other ones. And if you have any questions, go ahead and drop them in the comment section below. I read and reply to every single one. And make sure you hit that like button and subscribe for more in-depth Canva tutorials just like this one, as well as other videos to help you get more leads and subscribers to your email list and sales funnels. So until the next video, hit that like button, subscribe, and keep building the business you love.